Hi, Susan here, and today I'm going to attempt to do a tutorial for you today. And I'm using the Happy Dotting Company mold for the 3.75 molded stone. I've made this using hydrostone gypsum cement. It's very nice and smooth and easy to paint. I have painted one coat of Liquitex black gesso as a primer, and this gives really good tooth for your paints to adhere to, and it also gives a beautiful black background, which the majority of my stones is what I use. I'm using a little spinner, well used, well loved, with a little silicone mat just so it doesn't slip around. I have also from the Happy Dotting Company, which can come with some, or you can purchase this with the mold. It's an stencil, template, whatever you'd like to call it. And I'm going to mark out all my lines, and I will do that and come back in just a moment. I am also using today the Happy Dotting Company tools that come in a big set. These are just some other things that don't need to be in here. So here's the full set. In the set, you also get a stylus, an ellipse tool, which creates different shapes, which is nice. You can also use a screwdriver head, but why do that when you've got this beautiful set? I will also be using, from Happy Dotting Company, the little pointed and stylus and small, about a 0.5 millimeter tipped tool at the end there. And we will see how this progresses here. I am going to be using blue and yellow today, and this is a piece that I'm going to create in respect to the Ukraine crisis. As it's been a year, I thought I would make a few more stones for the Ukrainian Culture Center locally for them to sell, and they can continue to raise funds for the war effort. So we'll see what happens here. We'll create a piece together. So I am going to be using the Happy Dotting Company tools today. If you don't have the Happy Dotting Company tools, just know that this number on her tools is 8, and that means 8 millimeters. And if you're not sure what the size of your tools are, like if you have the DIY Mandala stone tools, you could easily get a tool conversion chart. This one is a brand new chart from Z Dot Designs. And she's got here pretty much all the most popular sets that you can find. So an 8 in a DIY tool would be a 16, sorry, other way around, 8 in the Happy Dotting Company millimeters. The 16 is 8 millimeters according to the chart. So that way you'll get the same size. Yeah, it's not easy when there's so many different tools on the market. It's even worse with styluses, and I think so many people, I think that's one of the biggest questions that people ask me is, what styluses do you have? What are the sizes? Blah, 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 and on it goes. And all I can say is I'm gonna show you something that I think you will find amusing. Yeah, these are what I use. These are also what I have, because I like to experiment and maybe save you guys some money down the road. But what I've found is there is no major difference in the ends of these tools. The differences I find are just the body of the tools. I do like this one because it has an ergonomic feel to it. These ones I got, also I like that they have this sort of, you know, little holder there. Those are from this company, EK Tools, embossing stylus set. They say, I like the sizes in these ones too. 1 millimeter, 1.5, that would be this one. 2 millimeter, 3, and a 3, and then this one would be a 4 and a 0.2. So those I find are really the only sizes I really use, and you can always make bigger or smaller dots depending on the amount of paint you use. So for tutorials, this is where I find it a little hard, because you want to be able to paint the design that I create exactly, but it's always going to be really hard for me to give you the most accurate size, other than, you know, what I like pretty much is a 1 millimeter. Where are we here? This is, I use the 1, I use the 2 the most, and where's my small one? And a 0.5. Those are the three sizes I use the most. Occasionally the 2.5, and then I just adjust it with the amount of paint I use. So I hope that gives you a little bit of information. These are the Butte Galleria ones, and I used a calibrator to get the sizing because I didn't really trust their website info, or you can just do your own measurements and see that's 2 millimeters on something like that. Okay, let's get started. Enough blithering away here.
Thank you.
so here is layer one done. And I am going to do something a little bit different for layer two. I'm going to utilize some chunky glitter. These are by Recollections. This is called Marine. And I get these from Michael's in Canada. I don't have a yellow, so I'm just going to improvise a little bit here, but we're going to do the blue. And when I seal this with resin, that's when the magic really happens with these. So I'm just going to pour some in there. I'm just going to use a little bit of Mod Podge, this type here, just for it to adhere to. And you'll see what happens here. Now, where is my picker? Okay, so I've added a few more in there just for fun. You figure out where you want to put your little glitter spots. Or if you wanted to add glitter, like I did into the yellow spots. But yeah, I will let this dry and then I'll resin it and then I'll show you how these little mirrors just, well, they're not mirrors, but they look like mirrors once they're under resin. So we'll check back in a minute.